Hi, I'm Cody Smith, Technical Support Manager for Cloyes Gear and Products. In this video, we will show you how to service the time and chain system in 2004 to 2010 Ford 5.4 3-valve V8 engines using Cloyes aftermarket replacement components. This procedure will closely resemble the installation for all Ford modular Triton series engines, including the 4.6, 5.4, and 6.8 2-valve, 3-valve, and 4-valve per cylinder V8 and V10 engines. Cloyes has exclusively developed and designed critical components for our kit coverage. We have 23 total kits that cover stock replacement modular applications from 1994 through 2011. We also have a full line of billet high performance adjustable premium product for a limited time. Call me for availability. The focus today is the installation of the 9-0391SB timing kit for all 5.4 liter 3-valve engines from 2004 to 2010. The kit will contain tensioners, guides, chains, and the crank sprocket. Note that the cam sprockets used in the 3-valve engines are variable cam timing phasor units. They will not be included in this kit. Please check the Cloyes Buyer's Guide on our website for correct kit applications. A few quick notes before we get started. Timing service can be done with the engine in the vehicle. Access to the timing components requires removal of the valve covers and the front engine cover. Make note that the front engine cover is indexed to the engine block with dowels and mates to the oil pan at the bottom. One more thing, this is an interference engine. First, you will need to rotate the engine so the crankshaft key is approximately at 12 o'clock and the R mark on your right bank passenger side cam and the L mark on your left bank driver side cam are both up. If the marks on your cam phasors are opposite from what I just described, then rotate the crankshaft one full revolution and check again. You are now ready for timing system disassembly. Start by removing the crankshaft sensor ring. Note the direction that the sensor ring will need to be reinstalled. Next, remove the timing chain tensioners from both banks. Now remove the pivoting tensioner guides. You can then remove the timing chains followed by the crankshaft sprocket. Next, remove chain guides. Now, install the camshaft sprocket holding tool on the cylinder head, engaging it with the cam phasor. We are using the holding tool out of the OTC 6681 kit. Once the tool is installed, you can remove the cam phasor bolt and the cam phasor. Discard the phasor bolt. These are torque to yield bolts and are not meant to be reused. Repeat the process on the other cylinder head. In this application, the right bank and left bank chains are the same. Both are symmetrical with sequential marked outer links on one end and one single marked link on the other. The two sequential marked links will straddle the appropriate mark on the cam phasors, and the single marked link will align to the crankshaft sprocket's timing mark. The 4.6 liter chains are similar, however, they will only have one marked link on each end of the chain. The marked links will align directly with the camshaft and crankshaft sprocket timing marks on the 4.6 liter applications. The timing chain tensioners have a crucial mating surface with seal. For example, the used OE tensioner shown here has a rip seal. Take note, the Cloyes exclusive tensioner is improved with a fully supported O-ring seal design. With the engine opened up, it is an opportune time to change the VCT solenoid control valves if necessary. If you are making this repair due to a rattle at idle or you are attempting to remedy unstable chain operation, you may have an issue with the variable cam timing system, including possible issues with the cam phasors, control solenoids, or oil pressure feed to the VCT components. If you are suspect that you have an engine that is severely worn or has suffered lack of maintenance, it is recommended to inspect the camshafts and camshaft journals. Test and confirm a minimum hot idle oil pressure of 25 PSI. This is an excellent overall test to determine engine health, but remember that overall healthy oil pressure does not indicate the cam journal clearance is within specification. This test should be conducted using the manufacturer specified engine oil. This is an example of a severely worn engine where you can see heavy scoring on the outside diameter of the camshaft journals, scoring on the camshaft journal bores in the head and camshaft journal main caps. The camshaft journal OD specification is 1.126 to 1.127 inches. A properly torqued camshaft journal bore should be within 1.128 to 1.129 inches, resulting in a journal OD to camshaft journal bore clearance of 1 to 3 thousandths. These specifications are critical to VCT function because the front cam journal feeds the VCT through the camshaft for retarded and advanced rotation. Camshaft and camshaft journal bores outside of the given specifications can allow for VCT oil supply crossflow, resulting in unstable VCT function. The front cam journal also sets the camshaft in play. In play specification is 1 to 7 thousandths. Also note, this feature is the oil feed and oil port for thrust bearing lubrication. We are now ready to start the assembly. Start by engaging the right bank cam phasor onto the right bank camshaft. Then loosely install the new phasor bolt. Install the cam holding tool. Then torque the phasor bolt to 30 foot-pounds plus an additional 90 degrees. Repeat this process for the left bank head and remove the cam holding tool. Install the crankshaft sprocket. Make sure the hub faces forward. Install time and chain guides on both banks. Torque all four bolts to 89 inch-pounds. We are now ready to install the timing chains. Install the left bank chain first on the inner row of the crankshaft sprocket. Straddle the appropriate mark on the cam phasor with the sequentially marked outer links of the chain and align the single marked link with the timing mark on the crankshaft sprocket. If the marks do not perfectly align, you can rotate the crankshaft slightly by hand using the harmonic balancer. Repeat this process on the right bank using the outer row of the teeth on the crankshaft sprocket. Install the time and chain tensioner guides. Before installation of the time and chain tensioners, make sure the mating surface of the cylinder heads are clean and inspect the oil feed port for debris or oil sludge buildup. Clean as necessary. Ensure to install the correct tensioner on each bank. The tensioners will be marked on the housings with an L for the left bank or driver's side and an R for the right bank or passenger side. As we stated earlier, inspect the mating seals before installation. Torque the tensioner bolts to 18 foot-pounds. Go ahead and check the timing marks one more time. Once confirmed, pull the activation clip on both tensioners. This concludes the timing system installation. You can now reinstall your reluctor wheel, your front engine cover, and your valve covers. Hey Cody, how's it going?
Good man, how are you?
If you got any questions, please call our tech line.
Please subscribe to our channel.
Good job.
Thanks. You too.